Please, all of you on the left, please. Just a second.
Excuse me.
Hi, thank you for coming in. The reason why we're here is, as you are all aware, some days back, Hafeez Saif has gone to the Lahore High Court and filed a petition saying that our film should be banned in Pakistan and that it's spreading poison. So ever since that has happened, we've been getting a lot of calls and messages from the media, you know, all of us, Sajid, Hussein, Saif and me. So that's the reason why we decided, if, you know, there is a lot of interest in what has happened, we thought we should have a press conference and be able to collectively talk about this issue. So I think what we'll do is we'll begin with Hussein. Let Hussein, since he's the author of the book on which the film is based, let him give a statement which represents what we feel about this issue, and then from there we'll take questions.
Friends, it's hilarious that a man, a wanted terrorist like Hafeez Saif, has approached Lahore High Court seeking a ban on the movie. Imagine, this man is a wanted terrorist by United States, United Kingdom, European Union, Australia and India. Just now I was telling Kabeer that Don ko 11 mulkon ki film police dhoond rahi hai, Hafeez Saif ko 50 mulkon ki police dhoond rahi hai. There is a pending red corner notice against him. United States has declared a bounty of $10 million on this man. A very top Pakistani official says that a free Hafeez Saif is a security threat to Pakistan. And this man goes and seek a ban against the movie, saying that it's spewing venom against Pakistan. He has not even seen the movie. He might have only seen the trailer. But he is trying to represent Pakistan. Imagine a man, a wanted terrorist, like who can be credited with the innocent blood of thousands and thousands of people, is representing Pakistan. I'm sure, I mean, Pakistani government or Pakistani people does not want to be represented by this kind of terrorist. But he has come forward and he has sort of ban against the movie. So, I mean, you guys decide. I think Pakistan should decide whether he should be allowed to speak on their behalf or not.
We're open for questions if anybody has any.
जहाँ तक पाकिस्तान की बात है, तो मुझे तो पहले से लगा था कि ये फिल्म पाकिस्तान में बैन होगी, क्योंकि ऐसे कुछ ऐसे टॉपिक्स हैं जो बिना फिल्म देखे या बिना रिव्यू के पाकिस्तान सीधी तरह से बैन कर दिए। हमने भी कुछ फिल्में बनाई हैं पास में जो पास हुई हैं पाकिस्तान में, लेकिन वो टाइप की फिल्म मत होती हैं। अगर एक रियलिस्टिक, जैसे ये फिल्म है जिसका बेस थोड़ा रियलिस्टिक हो, तो इट्स नो सरप्राइज फॉर मी दैट दिस फिल्म इज बैंड इन पाकिस्तान। ये तो
एक्चुअली क्या होता है कि थोड़े से जहाँ भी पॉलिटिकल बैकड्रॉप होता है फिल्म का, तो चांसेस हो जाते हैं कि फिल्म वहाँ नहीं दिखाई जाएगी। जैसे एजेंट विनोद हुई थी, मेरी खुद की फिल्म एक था टाइगर बैन हुई थी। तो आई थिंक जहाँ भी हल्का सा एक पॉलिटिकल बैकड्रॉप आता है, वहाँ चांसेस हैं। पाकिस्तान अभी फिलहाल में बैन हुई है, तो वो है एक, आई थिंक हम लोगों का रिलेशनशिप है कि जहाँ भी थोड़ी सी आप एक पॉलिटिकल बैकड्रॉप में जाएं, प्रॉब्लम क्रिएट हो जाती है। बट आज का मुद्दा ये नहीं है कि उन्होंने क्या किया, अभी तो उन्होंने देखी भी नहीं है फिल्म. आज का मुद्दा ये है कि वी आर रियली अम्यूज्ड कि एक वांटेड टेररिस्ट हैज गॉन एंड फाइल्ड अ पेटिशन सेइंग वी आर स्प्रेडिंग पॉइजन.
कबीर वन बाय वन सर, बट इन्होंने जो प्रेड लिखी थी सर, उनको इंडिया में थिएटरिकल रिलीज भी नहीं मिली थी जिसके बाद. सो डू यू थिंक दैट सर लेटर इट गॉट इट, सो डू थिंक दैट के योर सब्जेक्ट जो आपने लिया है सर आपको इंडिया में. अच्छा स्टार्ट अगेन सर, द बुक दैट ही रोट दैट इज ब्लैक फ्राइडे सर, अनुराग कश्यप ने जो बनाई थी सर, उनको थिएटरिकल रिलीज भी इंडिया में नहीं मिल पाई थी, बट नाउ एटलीस्ट यू आर गेटिंग इट इन इंडिया. तो आई यू स्टिल कंसर्न अबाउट गेटिंग इट रिलीज ऑन पाकिस्तान और नो?
That's not the point. The point is that there is a certain representation of the film that's happening. There is a person, the person who is talking about it. We are just finding it very amusing that a person like that would actually go to the extent of going to the court and, you know, saying that the film is spreading poison. I mean, he needs to look at what his position has been, what he represents. He represents hate agenda. He represents hate politics. So for somebody like him, you know, one of the most wanted terrorists in the world, to come up and say this about our film is just something that I find really amusing.
I just want to add that actually this movie made, there are also a lot of good Pakistanis that are shown. So it's not just, you know, Hafeez Saeed or other bad elements. There are also good Pakistanis who are shown as a person who are very helpful, who are very nice, who are very cordial. Now there are few bad elements, and these bad elements actually bring bad name to the country. So it's like people like Hafeez Saeed who has tarnished the reputation of a nation like Pakistan.
I'd also just like to say something. I think one important fact is that all the people involved in the making of this film are Indian Muslims. I think we have a point of view. This is a very patriotic film. I was very excited and happy to get this role because it's one of the most heroic parts that I've ever been offered. The film being banned in Pakistan is something that is expected because the film has got a real base. 26/11 happened. I think everybody knows what the facts are. Everybody knows who's responsible. And why should we always make films on foreign subjects or action films inspired by events happening somewhere else or fictitious events when we have something that's happened like this in our own country, which we would like to see a stronger response to in the future? So the film is half fiction and half fact. And you know, I'm very proud of the movie, and I'm very much looking forward to the release.
But is it official that it is back?
No, not yet. No, but
Pakistani court has given a date until 13th August for the Pakistani government to respond to the petition of Hafeez Saeed. I'm seriously hoping that at least they see the movie and they don't decide unilaterally on Hafeez Saeed's petition.
Sorry, I was also, what I was trying to say earlier also was, whenever we've made films on these subjects, I think all of us like to have a, I'm saying that when we make films on this subject, we like to have a balanced point of view. Nobody is against a particular religion, nobody is against Pakistan as a country. It is a complex relationship, we know that, we play sports together, we're culturally involved, but on certain levels we've also spilled blood against each other. So, depending on the issue, there are different approaches. It's an honest film. I think one of the reasons I've enjoyed working with Kabeer is there is integrity. He understands the subject well. So, whether it's in the past, Sri Ram Raghavan, who's also an intelligent man, or Kabeer now, I don't think we would ever treat the subject in a jingoistic or sensational way. I'm very proud of the way they've handled it. And I think before passing judgment, everyone should see the film.
Market share, honestly, I would not know that. Sajid would know, but I think that's not the point. It's not, you know, we don't want our films to release there because, you know, there's a big market or there's some revenue. It's just that when you make a film, you should be allowed to express what you want to express, and you should not always be on your toes, you know, array, if I do this, this might get banned. If I do that, it might get banned. Because that way, then you are never free with your creative process. You should be able to say something, whatever you want, and even if you have a political backdrop, you should be able to express what you want to. Of course, you should not be offensive and you should not do something deliberately to hurt, you know, the sentiments of a country or a community. And that's what we've done. You know, what I'm finding unfortunate about this situation is that a person who is divisive, a person whose politics stand for division and hate, is trying to represent himself as the face of a country. The film is not anti any country, it's anti-terrorism.
The reason why we greenlight a film, Hindi. Last year, we greenlighted a book called 82 States. It was a bestseller. Same year, this book was released, Mumbai Avengers, and it was a bestseller. There was no, when the book was released, there was no, all over the world, it was sold well. There was a lovely response to the book on the Twitter, digitally. When we greenlighted the film, we wanted the country and the world to see it. There are friends of ours in Pakistan, Karachi, Lahore, there are family of ours. They want to see this film. After they see the film and the board decides it's not good for the country, we wouldn't mind it. But before seeing the film, going to the court, we feel it's unreasonable.
When you said them, who? Of course, we have to show it to the censor boards if you want the film passed over there. That's a date that will be decided according to whatever the procedures are.
But Kabeer, isn't it a mystery that, you know, the Lahore High Court has actually acknowledged the petition? How is a criminal's petition being acknowledged by the court?
I mean, that honestly is something that I will not be able to comment on. As I said, I find it very amusing that somebody like that who has a 10 million bounty on his head is going to a court and filing petitions.
Is he a criminal by Pakistan's law as well? Is he
put under house arrest twice? And after 2000 attacks, in December 19, he was arrested. He was put under house arrest for a year and a half. Two cases were filed against him and it went to the Supreme Court. So there is also a pending red corner notice issued against him by United States. They've also placed a bounty of $10 million against him if he's not a wanted criminal. As I said in the beginning, that it's United States, United Kingdom, Australia, European Union, everyone is like trying to hunt for this man. So he's not a criminal, he's a terrorist. A man who has like killed hundreds and thousands of people.
जी बिल्कुल. आई थिंक हर फिल्म मेकर को, हर राइटर को, हर आर्टिस्ट को एक फ्रीडम होनी चाहिए, फ्रीडम ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन होनी चाहिए और ऐसा माहौल होना चाहिए अपने मुल्क में या जहाँ भी वो ऑपरेट करते हैं कि अननेसेसरी रिस्ट्रिक्शंस ना लगाएं. बिकॉज आप क्रिएटिवली अगर कुछ एक्सप्रेस करना चाहते हैं, हाँ, आप में एक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी होनी चाहिए कि आप कुछ ऐसा ना करें जो जिससे आपको मालूम है आप किसी को ऑफेंड कर सकते हैं, या डिलिब्रेटली कुछ ऐसा डिज़ाइन करें जो किसी कम्युनिटी या किसी मुल्क को ऑफेंड कर सकता है. लेकिन वो एक सेल्फ सेंसरशिप होती है, वो हर एक आर्टिस्ट में होनी चाहिए. और हर एक इंसान जो अपने आइडियाज़ को ऐसे एक्सप्रेस करना चाहता है क्रिएटिव, ये सेंसरशिप होनी चाहिए. उसके अलावा ये अननेसेसरी जो रिस्ट्रिक्शंस और चीज़ें हम डालते हैं कि ये मत करो, वो मत करो, ऐसे मत दिखाओ, ऐसे मत करो, वो नहीं होना चाहिए. True, I think that's true. We need to actually ignore any comments from the person. And the reason why we are talking here today is there has been a lot of interest from the media ever since this happened a couple of days back. And that's the reason we decided that we should come together on a platform and then speak, you know, collectively. That's the only reason. Otherwise, you're absolutely right. Actually, we should be ignoring any comments from such quarters. But that, you know, that's the, our relationship is complicated. So the problem is that as long as you talk about people-to-people friendship, which we must talk about, it's fine. But the moment you go political, you know, there's a certain perception that we'll always be anti the establishment, and it's sad because it is these elements that prevent people-to-people friendship. And so in that sense, it comes from the same sort of a prism, that unless movements are my society, because every time their actions is what prevents. So what I was trying to say is that it is these elements that actually prevent people-to-people friendship. And it is only after these kind of elements are removed from our society will true warmth between, you know, the people of the two countries exist. Because unless these people are stopped, we'll never be able to generate an atmosphere and an environment where there can be people-to-people friendship. Again, नहीं हम प्रॉब्लम क्या कर रहे हैं हम फिर लोग और एस्टैब्लिशमेंट को जोड़ रहे हैं हम वो दैट इज द कॉमन मिस्टेक वी मेक हम जब भी हम इंडिया या पाकिस्तान की बात करते हैं तो हमें पूरा एक अमॉर्फस मास एक एज अ होल दिखता है ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि हम पॉलिटिक्स और लोगों को सेपरेट करके प्रोसीड करें तो अभी जैसे आपने बोला उनको नहीं चाहिए उन्होंने नहीं बोला है जब तक वहां रिलीज नहीं होगी तब तक हमें पब्लिक का रिएक्शन मिल ही नहीं सकता ये सब डिसीजंस एट अ पॉलिटिकल लेवल हो जाती हैं अगर सेंसर भी बैन कर रही है अलाउ कर रही है दे आर पार्ट ऑफ द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट सो अनफॉर्चुनेटली ये हमें हमारी जो एक परसेप्शन है कि अ कंट्री इज वन सॉर्ट ऑफ बिग मास्क